She's going to be here with Dr. Ed Montgomery. Montgomery, of course, is the man who is in charge of taking care of communities, as well as auto workers and other workers who have been displaced because of the sagging auto industry. The governor has been talking for a good long while about how things need to change in terms of going from automotive to things like wind turbine and that kind of manufacturing, something that Cascade Engineering is already doing. And the governor joins us now, just literally getting out of the vehicle. Governor, thanks for your time, as always. What can you say to Dr. Montgomery today? What can you tell him that you haven't already told the administration? After all, we're already receiving more money than some states. So what will you ask him to do in terms of helping those areas hardest hit by the automotive downturn?
Obviously, Rick, we're all about jobs. And so brainstorming with him about how the administration can help us to create or lure jobs here is really so much of this focus. There's also a lot of restrictions on some of these federal funds, particularly when it comes to unemployment or Workforce Investment Act. We'd like some more flexibility on that to be able to help people during this time. So both jobs and some administrative flexibility is a lot of what we're going to be focusing on. And just very quickly, the suppliers to the automotive industry also need access to capital. And we're going to ask for the federal government to provide us with the ability to have those loans available for them so they can retool to do things like Cascade is doing.
When you look at the bigger picture, knowing that the economic news for the state was certainly not good this week, we know that Chrysler plants are going to be shut down. That's not going to help the state's budget picture, nor will it help the automotive picture, at least in the short term. How confident are you that this additional help from Dr. Montgomery making a return trip and spending a lot of time in Michigan, how confident are you that the feds are getting the message that Michigan is being hit harder than many other places?
Oh, I think that they know, because of what's happening in the auto industry and their engagement with it, that Michigan has been hit harder than any other state in the country. But they also are focused on the things that we're focused on. For example, one of the things in the Recovery Act is for battery technology. We are asking them to judge our battery proposals on the merits, meaning that if they judge them on the merits, then they won't spread around that money to other states. They'll put it where it needs to be, which is right here in Michigan. So those kind of things, they absolutely know that we are hit hardest. They absolutely know that they should be saying to us, help is on the way.
Quickly, Governor, yesterday a significant announcement about Ford building new alternative fuel vehicles in Michigan. That was a big step to keeping the auto industry in Michigan. How gratifying was it to see them make that investment?
Well, it was great. Obviously, we have put a lot into making sure. And it's not just alternative fuels, it's a fully electric, battery electric vehicle. So they're going to make 6 small vehicles. Normally they would have made those probably in Mexico or in somewhere else. They've decided to plunk and put them in the United States, obviously Michigan getting the first battery vehicle. Very, very important for us. They need to pick a battery partner for that. We want the batteries built here as well.
Governor, thank you for your time as always. We'll be with the governor later today as she tours here at Cascade Engineering and is with Dr. Ed Montgomery, who is the man who is in charge of taking care of communities and workers who are hardest hit by the downturn in the automotive industry. We'll have continuing coverage at woodtv.com and, of course, on 24-Hour News 8 at 5 o'clock. Live at Cascade Engineering, I'm Rick Albin. Back to you.